News Review from BBC Learning English.
Hello and welcome to News Review, the programme where we show you how to use the language from the latest news stories in your everyday English. Hi, I'm Neil. Joining me today is Dan. Hi, Dan.
Hello.
What's our story?
It's a story about a surprise at the Emmy Awards.
Ah, the Emmy Awards. Okay, let's find out some more about that from this BBC World Service report.
Claire Foy won her first Emmy for playing the Queen. The big drama and comedy awards went to the fantasy Game of Thrones and 50s period piece The Marvelous Mrs Maisel. But everyone was upstaged by Glenn Weiss, who won for directing the Oscars TV show and used his acceptance speech to propose to his girlfriend.
So, the Emmys are like the Oscars, but for television programmes. Among the winners were Claire Foy for her role as Queen Elizabeth II, the fantasy series Game of Thrones, and the period drama The Marvelous Mrs Maisel. Excuse me, I'll say that again. The Marvelous Mrs Maisel. It's a lot of M's. But what everyone really, really noticed was when Glenn Weiss, who is a director, used his acceptance speech to propose to his girlfriend. It was a complete surprise. It was very warmly received by the audience. And she said yes.
Just as well, really, isn't it?
Yes.
I've been quite embarrassed.
Bit of a chance.
Otherwise. So you've been reading up on this story at the various news websites and picking out vocabulary that's useful. What have you got?
We've got Pops question, or Pops the question, steals the show and lost it.
Okay, Pops the question, steals the show and lost it. Your first headline, please, then.
Our first headline comes from twincities.com and says, Oscars director wins Emmy, Pops question to girlfriend.
Pops the question, ask someone to marry them.
That's right. So if you pop the question, you ask someone to marry you. Now, this is a fixed phrase. It's always the same. You pop the question or someone pops the question. It's always the question.
Yeah.
So the article there.
Dropped in the...
Absolutely. Dropped in the headline.
In the headline.
That's to make it shorter, punchier.
Yeah, that happens, but we would never say it.
No,
we would,
always
include
question.
The.
Absolutely, we always have the. And there's lots of other ways to say it as well. So you can become engaged to someone. You can ask for someone's hand in marriage. You can even go down on one knee, which doesn't mean you physically go down on one knee. It means exactly the same thing. Or, of course, we have that simple verb, which is, Neil?
To propose.
Propose. That's
it. Yeah. Okay. So someone says they're telling me about something that happened at the weekend. And, you know, my boyfriend popped the question. How do I know which question? How do I know he didn't say... You know, she didn't say, you know,
would you like a pizza or something like that?
Yeah.
Pop the question only has one meaning. Mm-hmm. It always means the same thing, and it is to ask for someone's hand in marriage or to propose. So if someone popped the question, if they said that to you, I would say, congratulations. Did you say yes? Actually, maybe say, did you say yes first?
Yeah.
And then say congratulations. Otherwise, it's a disaster.
Absolutely. Your next headline.
All right. Our next headline comes from ABC News and says, Emmy winner steals the show, proposing to longtime girlfriend on stage.
Steals the show, becomes the most impressive thing at an event.
Exactly. Now, let's go to the context of acting and a theatre. In the theatre, we have, let's say, lots of different actors, but we have one major actor who everybody knows is very, very famous, and we have a minor actor who almost nobody knows. However, during the performance, it becomes clear that the minor actor's performance is better than the major actor's performance. And so the audience starts paying attention to them. They have stolen the show. In other words, they have become the center of attention, they have earned more praise, or they have become more impressive than anyone else in that given situation.
And it's not just the theatre we can
use
to talk about.
Exactly.
This.
It could be sporting events. It could be at a party. Imagine you go to a party and everybody says, let's do a trick each.
Mm.
So everybody has a different trick, but one person's trick will be most impressive. They will have stolen the show.
Like that time when you turned up at the BBC Learning English Christmas party in that gold zoot suit.
I thought we'd never talk about that again. Yes, exactly. My shiny zoot suit with my big feather in my hat. I feel like I stole the show.
You stole the show. But it wasn't a performance, it was a party.
Exactly. It was a party. So nothing to do with that. Now, What's really nice about stealing the show is you gain the attention in a very positive way. It's not a bad thing to steal the show. It means that you gain praise and acclaim. Mm. However, if you'd like to say the same thing in a slightly less positive way, a more negative way, then you can steal the limelight. Now, this is the same thing, but when you steal the limelight, you take the attention from someone else and put it on yourself.
Yeah.
Which is not necessarily a nice thing to do.
No.
No. So, for example...
You've got an example, haven't you?
I do.
A children's party.
That's right. So, my poor brother, when my brother was about 6 years old, we had a garden party. Mm. All of his friends from his class were there, and everybody was having a really nice time until one of his friends from his class, Vanessa, fell in the pond.
Oh, no.
That was terrible. So, she was completely drenched, covered in frog spawn and all sorts of horrible things, and she completely stole the limelight from my brother. Because after that point... No one could talk about the party anymore. It was all about poor Vanessa.
The party wasn't about your brother anymore.
It was
all about poor Vanessa.
That's right. She stole the limelight.
That's it. Moving on to our final headline.
Our final headline comes from Slate.com and says, an Emmy's acceptance speech turned into a marriage proposal and the audience lost it.
Lost it. Lost control.
That's right. So it is control.
It is control.
It it is control. Self-control.
Yeah.
Emotional control.
Yeah.
Possibly even control over your actions. That depends on the situation. And that's what's nice about this phrase, because you can put it in lots of different emotional contexts. Mm. For example, if you've had a really bad day at work, the boss is really riding you, and you leave work feeling very, very stressed, and then you get on the train and somebody steps on your foot.
Oh, no.
Yeah.
You're going to lose it.
You're going to lose it. So you're going to start shouting, screaming, what are you doing? Mind where you're going?
Yeah.
People are going to look at you and go, whoa, that guy's really losing it.
Yeah.
But you only stepped on your foot. Calm down, you know?
Mm.
So it could be very, very negative.
Yeah.
You might lose it at the end of a movie.
Ah,
it's a very teary ending to a movie, very sad.
Have you seen Coco?
Yes, I have, actually, yeah.
Oh, man.
Did you lose it at the end of Coco?
Everybody lost it at the end of Coco.
Floods. They're good at that, aren't they? So, yes, you can lose it from sadness. You might cry and you not be able to stop crying.
Mm.
And, of course, someone could tell you a joke and you absolutely lose it laughing. I mean, you can't stop laughing. You can't control yourself just like that.
Come on, try.
A joke? No. Really?
No. No pressure. Now you're losing it. Okay. Before we recap over our vocabulary, of course, we have our social media challenge. And we ask the following question. Steal somebody's blank means upstage. Now, in that blank, is it A, shadow, B, thunder, or C, cheese? What's the answer and how is the response?
Well, the answer is B, thunder. If you steal somebody's thunder, you upstage them. And stealing somebody's thunder and stealing the limelight from somebody means the same thing, basically. Yep. So well done to everybody who got B. I'd like to say well done on Instagram to Armin Summers. Well done on Facebook to Bright Pascal Pascal. And well done on Twitter to Farouk Akyuz.
Yes, well done to everyone. Now, just time to recap that vocabulary.
All right. So first of all, we had pops the question, asks someone to marry them, steals the show, becomes the most impressive thing at an event, and lost it, lost control.
If you would like to test yourself on today's vocabulary, there's a quiz you can take on our website, bbclearningenglish.com, where you can find all kinds of other videos and activities to help you improve your English. And we have an app.
We do indeed. Free to download, free to use, all of our content on there wherever you need it.
Thank you for joining us. Join us again next week. Goodbye.
Goodbye.
News review from BBC Learning English.